Welcome to our tutorial on understanding the essential concepts of Looker Studio. Today we will look into the basic concepts and techniques that are required to use the Looker Studio. We will learn to connect to the datasets, transform the data, visualize the data, and share the reports. Connecting to the datasets requires the understanding of connectors and data sources. To transform the data in Looker Studio, you must know how to aggregate the data, blend the datasets, and create calculated fields. Reports are used in Looker Studio for visualization. These reports are made up of various components. Components include charts, controls and others, such as text boxes, buttons, filters, etc. Finally, when the report is completed in Looker Studio, it is shared. Sharing involves credentials and permissions. Let's discuss these concepts in detail, using live demonstration in Looker Studio. Let's go to the Looker Studio, using Looker Studio URL. In the Looker Studio, click on the Create button, and then the Data Source button. Here you can find all the connectors. Using these connectors, you can connect to various datasets. Let's connect to a dataset, using Google Sheets connector. Here you will find all the Google Sheets that you can connect to. Let's connect to one of the Google Sheets. You can rename your data source as well. Press Connect to connect to the data set. Your data source has now been created. These are all the fields in your data set. You can also edit your connection using the Edit Connection button at any time. Data Credentials allows you to define whose credentials are used when data is accessed. By default, owner's credentials are used, which can be changed to viewer's credentials as well. You can set the data freshness, the update frequency of data source, between 15 minutes to 12 hours. By default, it is 15 minutes. There are third-party visuals which you can use in your reports. These are called community visualizations. By default, they have access to your data, which you can turn off at any time using this feature. You can edit your fields in your reports. This includes changing their names, data types, etc. However, you can enable and disable this feature here. You can create parameters in your data source. Parameters are like variables. They can be used in formulas, calculated fields, and queries. You can create a parameter using the Add a Parameter button. Parameters require names, IDs, and data types, which can be defined while adding parameters. We will choose whole number as data type. Let's enter the world population here. Once saved, the parameter will be added to the data source. Here, you can also add calculated fields to your data source. Press Add a Field button. Enter the name for field you want to create. Now enter the formula for your field here. Here, we will use the total population parameter we previously created. Save the field to add it to your data source. It will be available in the list of fields. You can also set the default aggregation for your field. You can use the Create Report button, or go to the Looker Studio, to create a report. You can either use a connector, or an already created data source, to create a report. We will use the data source that we created, to create a report. Add the data to the report. Your data is now available for visualization. You can add more data sets directly, using the Add Data button. This will take you to the Add Data window, where you can either use a connector, or a data source, to connect to a data set. This time, let's connect to a data set, using a connector. Select the data set, and press Add button, to add the data to your report. Press the Add to Report button. Our second data set is now added. You can combine data from various tables, and use fields from all tables in your report. It is called blending the data. You can blend data using resource menu. Click on the Manage Blends button, and then add a blend to your report. The GDP table has already been added, we can add other tables to blend data. You should add fields from available fields into the dimensions and metrics. Press on the Join Another Table, to add another table to the blend. Just like before, add dimensions and metrics from available fields. You can give appropriate names to your tables as well. Let's call Table 1, GDP, and Table 2, Population. Now you must configure the join. This is equivalent of SQL join. You can select a join from the list of 5 joins. We will choose the left join, where all data will be taken from left table, which is GDP table, and matching data will be taken from right tables, such as population table. Press the Save button, to save the join, and then press the Save button, to save the blend as well. Now you can close the blend, and get back to your report, where blend will be available for visualization. Let's delete the system-generated visualizations first. Let's start our visualization, by adding a text box, which will act as heading for the report. You can add controls from Add a Control menu. Let's add a drop-down list, to filter the countries. Here you can check and uncheck countries, to show or hide in your report. Let's add a pie chart showing population percent, which we created in a calculated field, using the total population parameter earlier. Add country field to the dimension area. Our country filter will be useful here, to hide the world data from the visualizations. Let's add country field, from the blended data. This will automatically add a map chart. Now, add the population field, to as the bubble size. Let's create a copy of the same chart, to use it to display GDPs. Replace the population field, with the GDP field. To display both GDP and population in same chart, let's add country field to the report. Change the chart type, to a column chart. Add both GDP and population fields, to the metric area. And this is how you add controls, charts and other visualizations to your report, in Looker Studio. Sharing a report is fairly easy. You can share report using the share button. You can invite people with as viewers or editors. Viewers can only view the reports. Editors can also edit the reports. You can also share reports using scheduled delivery, where you can deliver reports automatically to the recipients on defined frequencies, at predefined time. You can also define filters in email delivery. You can also share a link to your report, using the share link option. You can change sharing settings as well. By default, link is restricted, which you can change to public as well. Restricted means, only the people with the link can access the report. Another method of sharing reports is to embed them in your website. You can use the code in Embed Report window, to embed Looker Studio reports into your website or any HTML page. You can set the height and width of the iframe here. You can copy this code, and paste it into an HTML page, to display and share the report. Finally, you can download a Looker Studio report, as a PDF file which you can share with anyone you like. This concludes our tutorial on essential Looker Studio concepts and techniques. Link to the Looker Studio report is placed in the description below. Don't hesitate to ask any question, or leave a feedback in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.